Now I'd like to talk about indications for screening breast MRI, according to the Society of Breast Imaging. The indications include BRCA1 or BRCA2 genetic mutation carriers, people with untested first degree relatives of proven BRCA mutation carriers, women with a greater than 20% lifetime risk of breast cancer based on family history, most commonly using the Gale model to assess for their risk, women with histories of chest irradiation due to Hodgkin's lymphoma, women with newly diagnosed breast cancer and a normal contralateral breast by conventional imaging. So essentially what we're doing is we are screening the contralateral breast with MRI at the time of diagnosis to ensure we're not missing additional cancers. And it may be considered in women with between 15 and 20% lifetime risk for breast cancer on the basis of personal history of breast or ovarian cancer, or a history of biopsy-proven lobular neoplasia or atypical ductal hyperplasia. So let's talk about the sensitivity and specificity for screening breast MRI and some of the other metrics. Screening breast MRI is great because it has an incredible high sensitivity, greater than 90%. The only problem is it has a low specificity, around 72%. So this results in a lot of false positives and a high biopsy rate, which a lot of patients don't like because it induces a lot of anxiety. The cancer detection rate for breast MRI is 10.8 per 1,000 exams, which is very impressive. Mammography, remember, is about 8.2 per 1,000 exams. One downside is that the exam is hormonally dependent. We give gadolinium-based contrast to the patient, and when the breast is very hormonally active, you get a lot of background enhancement, which can make it difficult to read. Thus, it's important to image the breast during the most quiescent phase of the menstrual cycle to eliminate this background. And that is usually between day 7 and 14 of the menstrual cycle, which limits the amount of time when a patient can get a breast MRI and requires very meticulous scheduling. And that is all for indications for screening breast MRI.